catch all my brothers ballin', ain't shootin' no bricks. Hold up, check me out. I think the tables done turned. Forget the bridges we done built, this time I let them all burn. They tried to count me out. Well, now it's the word. I bring it paper, paper, paper from the first to the first. They count me out. Now count me in. Oh, I'm hot. Sizzling. What they say?
On God.
Only ever care about one thing.
Ching, ching, ching.
Cha-chain, cha-chain. Rackets, rackets.
Hit the bank.
Ba-bang, ba-bang. Put you in your place. Wait, they done got me started. Without me, it's not a party.
Nope.
Ma, he got it rocking. We bring havoc to your lobby. Tristan, he got shoddy. They gon' copy because we popping. Blues up in my wallet. If I like it, then I cop it. Hold up, check me out.
Hold up.
I think the tables done turned. Forget the bridges we done built. This time I let them all burn.
They tried to count me out.
Well, now it's the word.
I
bring
it
paper, paper, paper from the first to the first.
They
count me out.
Yeah, yeah.
Now count me in. Oh, I'm hot. Sizzling.
Oh,
count me out.
Nah, nah.
It all begins.
Right here.
Right now. Catch me if you can.
So it's not nice.
Oh no, oh man, I just made a mess. When I run it, ain't no stopping, I'll never rest. Down said hunt, kick a punt, then I make a catch. 5,000 ones in an hour, I'ma make it stretch. I just made a mess, I just made a mess. I got cash by the bundle, so I'll never press. I just made a mess, I just made a mess. 50-yard TD, we do any case. Oh no.
As far as home field advantages go in the playoffs, there are few places tougher on a visiting team than this one. Sold out Empower Field at Mile High in Denver. Coming up, it's divisional round Saturday, and we've got an AFC battle on tap between the Buffalo Bills and the Denver Broncos. For a berth in the AFC Championship game, off we go in the divisional round of the NFL playoffs. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Broncos are going to take a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. They'll roll him out right. And incomplete on the deep ball.
As a former defender, I can feel their sigh of relief after that one, because when he breaks out of the pocket and you face a mobile quarterback, he causes all kind of problems in your secondary. They were able to force that incompletion.
This is James Robinson. And this may be a carbon copy as he'll again be stopped right at the line of scrimmage. Calling no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down. So now an early 3rd and 10 here on their opening drive.
Switch.
Kill. Middle. 56.
Six guys.
Now Allen. Complete to the running back, Matt Breida. And all the way down to the 35. A big play here for Buffalo.
Execution was one of their watchwords leading up to this one. And on that play, able to execute brilliantly here on this opening drive.
So that changes things a bit. Here's a 1st and 10 all the way down at the 35. On the run, it's Robinson. They follow up that gigantic gain with the tiniest of pickups, 1 yard.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
Still 9 remaining on 2nd down. To the air, Allen. Escaping the pressure right. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. It was the safety blitz that ultimately did the job, and they're going to credit him with a sack. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. So after the sack, Allen and the Bills with work to do on 3rd and long. Allen now looks to throw. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. Nice job keeping that opening drive alive. And they're in plus territory, that part of the field where you really want to convert on 3rd down. They did.
Big time pickup for them. And now I think the aggressive play callers think to themselves, this part of the field, I take my shot at the end zone. Because the closer you get to the end zone, the field gets condensed. Makes it a lot tougher to run those routes. You still got a chance to actually run past people right now. Take your shot at the end zone early in the down and distance count.
Allen now on 1st down. He will find Diggs in the end zone. Touchdown, Buffalo. Stephon Diggs there to make the grab. And the Bills are on the board first here in this division round matchup. Extra point through the snowflakes, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. And this will come out to the 25 as Hamler elects not to return it. First and 10, it's Hurts. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. So after the sack, they'll come up on a still manageable 2nd and 13. They'll run. This is Melvin Gordon. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to 3rd down.
He's taken down at the 33-yard line.
play action with Hurts. And the Bills are going to get him as he goes down. Gregory Russo in there to get him for a loss of 9 yards, and that also leads to fourth down. So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. And great special teams work here. This is knocking on the door of the five. They'll spot it at the 6-yard line.
Well, someone's going to be happy with that effort. You know who else is going to be happy? His defense.
Absolutely.
He's created a very long field for that offense to try to traverse.
And he got some help from Mr. Football there, checking up nicely. Good English on that punt. Here's a diving catch right side. I love that play because in the snow you think run, run, run. Big passing play there.
And defenders hate it, especially in open space, because trying to come under control, break down, and make a tackle in the open field, difficult in normal conditions. In these conditions, almost impossible.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Here's 2nd and 9, just a yard on that last run.
We want it. Come to my world.
Watch out, watch out, watch out. Watch the end.
Devin's a mic.
Watch the run, watch the run.
Now the Georgia Southern man, it's Matt Breida. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. That's going to go down as a loss of 5, and it brings up 3rd down.
We knew both of these safeties were good in run support, but how about the play we just saw there? How about that closing speed? Able to get to the outside part of the field and turn that play into a loss.
Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. He's got the hookup with Diggs. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
Someone sharp in this game. I mean, a touchdown pass on the first drive. He comes right back, and he's flinging it around really well here.
Really nice throw there to pick up the first down. You kind of just feel a laser focus and confidence about him, and I think we saw that this week, didn't we, talking to him and the coaches. They felt good about his performance coming up.
Yeah, I was really impressed with that last practice we saw when they went through 2-minute drill, when they went through all the different situations. Ball hardly hit the ground, and I thought, yeah, he might be locked in for this one.
Sliding out of the pocket. And Diggs has it. And all the way home for the Bills touchdown. Stephon Diggs with his 2nd touchdown of this opening quarter. And the Bills lead this now 13-0 here in the opening quarter of the ball game. So with a missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. They're forced to play catch-up early in this division round game as they search for a seat in the AFC Championship round. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Tackle made by Delano Hill. Here's 2nd and 10. Hurts. Man open. He's got it complete to Cortland Sutton. And he's out of bounds. Able to take this one up to the 35. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short. So it'll be 3rd and less than 1 yard. Throwing is Hurts. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he will have the Broncos' 1st down, maybe by about 1 yard, as they find a way to convert on 3rd and inches. So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. They'll run for the first time with the former Bearcat, Mike Boone. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Second quarter about to begin from Denver. It's the Broncos in possession of the football as they've got it second down and 11. They'll keep it on the ground. This time it's Gordon. It's a first down and more for Gordon. And he's going to get this into enemy territory at the 45. So following the run by Gordon, here's first and 10. Off the play fake, here's Hurts. And he's going to have the hook up to Sutton. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Flushed it, and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Gregory Russo able to drop him that time for his second sack of the evening.
For a rookie first-rounder, he's made a huge impact on this defense, but that tells me that they had a plan for him when they drafted him. Just turn him loose, do what you do best, go get the quarterback.
Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all, and I understand why. They look lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
Here comes the eighth play of the drive, and they need a full 10 yards on third down.
He's coming. Double up, double up.
Now it's the backup, Bridgewater. And he's got his tight end, Fant. Touchdown, Broncos. Noah Fant there to make the grab. And the Broncos draw a bit closer. McManus's point after is good. And the lead will shrink to 6. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Come to the line to start their next drive. And thus far, the weather has not slowed this offense down one bit. They've looked good so far in the first half.
They certainly have. And think back to our meeting with the head coach. And we asked him because we saw the forecast for this game, didn't we? We said, hey, have you prepared for this? And he talked about the different drills that they've done in adverse conditions, the wet ball drills, things of that nature. He said, I don't think it's going to slow us down much. We tend to handle it pretty well. And he's been right.
From the 31, Allen. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
Down, and they're going to throw with Allen. And the Broncos get there and take him down. It'll be a loss of 7 on the sack, and it brings up second.
He was still looking through his progressions and going through his receiver options, and while he was doing that, the defense got to him quickly in the pocket.
And it was a great example of zone coverage, well executed, well coordinated. All the receivers were covered, and he couldn't evade the rush back in the pocket.
He'll get about 4 as he's past the 35 to the 38-yard line.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you've got to continue to try and run and try and keep a defense honest.
And they also just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down.
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
22, pass 85, pass 85. Mike 22, Mike's coming, Mike. Man out.
On third and long, it's Allen. He's got it complete to Diggs, right side. And they're going to have this way down deep in Denver territory. A big play here for Buffalo.
The timing was absolutely true as he caught it working across the field. Plenty of space for him to roam. But notice how he keeps his head on a swivel, looking for defenders who may crop up out of nowhere. That turned into a big play.
So a big play as it gets him all the way down to the 20 now for first and 10. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. And his throw here is incomplete. Just his second incompletion so far. He's 8 for 10. I think he'll take 80%.
There's no doubt that he will. But if you're the defensive play caller, you better circle what you just dialed up on your play sheet and come back to it, because you just caused an incompletion. You need a few more of those.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20.
Check, check.
Out of the shotgun, Breida. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. That'll leave them with a third and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there.
Nice play, baby.
Quick throw, going to be caught by Diggs. Touchdown, Bills! Stephon Diggs saving his best for the playoffs with his third touchdown of the game. And the Bills will add on to their lead. Extra point, hug the upright a bit, but he gets it to go. And the lead now stands at 13. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. K.J. Hamler returning it. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Denver offense at the line, ready to go. And this not an easy situation. You're down early, in the elements, you're on the road. How do you get the mojo back?
Well, one thing is to remember that as an offensive player, you have a much better idea of what you're trying to accomplish and where you're trying to go than the defender. So in this case, because you know it, you can make your cuts with a little more decisiveness, maybe a second fake, some double moves, things of that nature, to go ahead and try and put some pressure on the defense. Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
The Broncos on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This time, it's 3rd and 3. Play action. Here's Hurts. And he will find his man, Sutton. That's complete. And all the way home for a Broncos score. Cortland Sutton, 65 yards. And the Broncos have cut it to within a score. And his kick is no good. Misses the PAT, a mistake there. And this remains a 7-point game. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
We remind you, as we've done all year, that coming up at halftime, we will visit with Jonathan Coachman, standing by in Orlando. He'll let you know what's going on here on a very eventful divisional round weekend. And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go 3 and out here and give the football right back, because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side. And all of a sudden,
you got a battle on your hands.
Now the Bills will use the second of their timeouts. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a third and three. To throw, it's Allen. And this pass broken up. And the contact well timed there, and now fourth down.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
On is the punter, Hawk, as he gets this one away. 33 yards is the distance on the punt there. And the Broncos take over, first down and 10. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. A little bit of flip the script. Quarter one, they struggled. Quarter two here, they put things together. And I guess sometimes, Charlie, you just come out and you have to get your feet underneath you in a ball game, right?
That's exactly right, because every now and then you don't come out of the gate as fast or as strong as you want to. Sometimes you have to ramp up into it or take a few hits along the way and figure it out. And that's what they've done so far. Slow start, but now they're starting to put it together.
Rolling to his right. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40.
Certainly making his presence felt in both the pass and the run game. He's having an impact.
Yeah, his first carry of the game right there. He had hurt him with his arm. Now he's showing that he can shuffle the puppies as well.
Down to lose one. Under 10. Under 10.
Hey. Now Gordon on first down. And he'll take it across midfield and into Buffalo territory. 55 rushing yards rushing for him now, as he has been strong here in the first half of this divisional round matchup. And just a yard to go here on second down. Now a give right side. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46.
Not your normal call in short yardage, but the toss works very well there. Big people out in front, being physical, and they pick up a first down.
But first down, Hurts. Left side here, that's the tight end Fan. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Now the Broncos going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Here's Hurts to throw. Eluding the pressure right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10.
He's tight right here. He's tight on the right. Tight on the right. We got three. We got.
Hurts sets up to throw it. That is taken in by the tight end Fan. Now the Broncos will use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And he's got his tight end Fan. Touchdown, Broncos. Noah Fant in the final seconds of the first half. And the Broncos have a chance to tie the game here in the final seconds of the half. Extra point from McManus is good. And we are tied here in the second quarter. Fitting for what's been a tight ball game. We're all even at 20 now as the kick's away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And you wonder if with Allen's arm, they might just take their chances by dialing up a long one. On first down, Allen. Going deep for Diggs. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
Certainly no lack of aggressiveness here. They were hoping for the home run play to get them 6 points. They're hoping for a catch, maybe a call. But they figure they can at least get into field goal range with a completion.
A final shot before half for Allen. And a dump off here to Robinson. And they're able to get this one across the 35. So it's on to halftime in this AFC divisional round matchup. As we send you on out to our studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Win or go home, that's the name of the game, and we're back underway with the second half of this AFC divisional round.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
I'll tell you, far from ideal conditions to play in, but neither offense has had much trouble. Plenty of points to go around. First and 10. Into the hands of Patrick, left side. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. On second down, they'll run with Gordon. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and now they're faced with a third and one. I see an extra defensive back on the field. Little surprise here on third and one. They'll go with Boone. And brought down, but the juke, a very nice juke, gives him the first down yardage here.
Man, what were they thinking on defense there? That looked like they were playing for the pass. That was third and short. Yeah, it was an easy pickup because they handed it to him. That was way too easy.
Just looked like absolute confusion defensively. Not sure why they were in that set.
Yeah, I'd say you ought to have a few men in the box there.
They'll run on first down. It's Gordon. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front. Because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 69 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. That's out to the flat for Gordon. And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch. I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
On first down, boom. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. He's obviously a bit of a shorter running back. Sometimes when he goes up the middle like that, he gets lost in there, and then he pops out for 10, 20 yards.
I actually asked NFL linebackers if that was true. Do you actually lose sight of some of the smaller running backs? And all of them confirmed that that can be a problem.
Think of it this way. Two of the top running backs in NFL history, Emmitt Smith, Barry Sanders, both 5'10".
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal. But down here near the goal line, you don't think of a cornerback in run coverage, but he made the stop.
Yeah, most of the cornerbacks we know, they want to be those pass defenders and take away one half of the field. But the best ones in the game are the complete cornerbacks, able to tackle and run support, as we just saw there.
A nice run there as he picks up six. It's going to be third and goal now.
And Brad, they went to a nickel defense, and that's a surprise this close to the goal line, because ordinarily you use the back end of the end zone, the sidelines, as extra defenders, and you want bigger people on the field to try and help against the run.
A big one coming in this divisional round playoff, third and goal. They'll run for it with Bo Scarborough, and he will take it in for a Bronco touchdown. Bo Scarborough, fine work there on the touchdown run, and the Broncos have taken the lead. McManus's point after is good, and they will take a 7-point lead. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Come to the line to start their next drive. And this game was all square at halftime, but now they find themselves down seven following the opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter.
And they need to take a good, relaxing, deep breath, don't you think? Because right now they might start to feel like they've got to play catch-up here and start matching them point for point. But it's...
Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Bryce Callahan. And he's able to take this one back to the 36-yard line.
Well, I get what he was trying to do. He was moving to his right and trying to shift the coverage, but instead he shifted the coverage also to the right and threw right into it for an interception.
They'll run on first down. Gordon, and he'll work this forward for about three at second down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a three-yard run. But for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Flush to his right. And Hurts able to show off some of that elusiveness as he slides to the ground there and in the process picks up the first down. They show run with three tight ends here on first down. Now they run from the gun with Gordon. Open space inside the 10. And he's all the way down to the 6-yard line. 97 yards for him on the ground now. He has been a tough man to bring down all night. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he gets him a little bit closer. He takes it from the 6 inside the 5 to the 4. Second and goal from inside the 5. They'll give it to Gordon out of the shotgun. And he is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown. Melvin Gordon taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Broncos push further out in front. Extra point from McManus is good. And the lead now up to 14. After the touchdown, out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
Second and six, just inside the 30.
Hey, we got a seal. We got a seal. We got a seal.
Better bring it.
Now Allen. Looking for Diggs, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Bronco defense has a touchdown. Now McManus for the extra point. And the lead now to three touchdowns at 21 points. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And fresh off the pick six, they've got to forget about that quickly.
In this case now, the guy throwing the ball, he's got to be like what we talk about with defensive backs who get beat for a long touchdown. Short-term memory, right back out there doing the things that he does best, and knowing that taking care of the ball is paramount, here's his opportunity.
It comes back to those defensive backs for the former DB, right?
I don't know where that comes from. It just kind of emerges out of me for some reason.
It's deep in there, right?
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. Now a give to Breida. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. Chalk that up as a four-yard loss. And now it's third down. Well, this is where the mile-high air really starts to affect an opposing offense. Guys moving a bit slowly here. It's third and long. One quarter remains for the right to advance to the AFC title game. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Bills on third down. They have been superb. 5 for 6 to this point. This is going to be third and 13. Here's Allen. He'll be brought down by the Broncos. It's a sack. It's a loss of 10 on the sack, and it leads to fourth.
Brandon, what I remember most about playing with guys who knew how to rush the passer, they would just tell you, just cover people for me, just long enough for me to get there, and that's exactly what happened on that play.
It'll wind up just a 35-yard punt, no return, and out will come the offense as they take over. Denver offense at the line, ready to go. If they can finish this one out, they'll book a date in the AFC title game next Sunday. And it looks good so far as they try to run some clock here in this fourth quarter. And he'll take it across midfield and into Buffalo territory. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. After the pickup of five, here's second and five. They'll look to throw. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line.
One of my old teammates called me the other day when he was watching the game. He's like, man, trying to watch an NFL game and trying to account for their passing game, that's difficult. And just when you think you get everything covered, here comes a back out of the backfield. In this case, he picks up a first down.
Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. On the slant, completes to Sutton. Touchdown, Broncos! Cortland Sutton, his second touchdown of the night. And the Broncos are drawing closer to a date in the AFC title